more than that, Russian invasion of Ukraine, a Chinese invasion of Taiwan would likely result in World War III. Due to the likelihood of a military response from the US and Japan, in the race for global dominance, China is the US's principal competitor. The US would see its bases in Okinawa and Guam as under threat if it allowed Beijing to seize control of Taiwan. And Japan would probably start working on its own nuclear arsenal. The US is likely to engage in military action if Taiwan is attacked in order to avert that catastrophe. Biden has stated that he will, even though the US is simply required to maintain the capability to do so, and is not legally required to militarily defend Taiwan under the terms of the 1979 Taiwan Relations Act. The fate of Ukrainians worries Taiwanese people. There are incomparable circumstances, which explains why. People in both locations have abandoned their respective ethnic identities, Russian and Chinese. It is now challenging to merge a national identity that is both Ukrainian and Russian. The percentage of Taiwanese who identify as Chinese has decreased from 50% to 30%, and that percentage has also decreased from those who claim both a Taiwanese and Chinese identity. The identity shift in Ukraine was a response of Russia's annexation of Crimea in 2014 and the fighting that ensued in the Donbas era, when China imposed a harsh national security law on Hong Kong in 2020, the identity shift in Taiwan gained momentum. This demonstrated to the Taiwanese what may be expected following national unification under One China, the Ukrainians' resolute resistance to the Russian invasion in February to March 2022. Can be partially attributed to the shift of national identities. Another justification is that Ukraine has increased its military capabilities since 2014. Taiwan is no different in this regard. Politics change as a result of the transformation of the national identity. 2014 saw a regime shift in Kyiv as a result of public activism. Pro-Russian candidates were unable to prevail in Ukrainian elections due to the country's loss of Crimea and the fighting in Donbas. The Democratic Progress Party's Tsai Ing-wen defeated KMT nominee for president of Taiwan's One China Party in 2016. By keeping the state's name as the Republic of China, she has not taken any steps to achieve de jure independence. But she has rejected the 1992 consensus, which maintains that there is only one China, but that is disagreement about what the term China means. Along the Taiwan Strait, this has caused tension. 2020 saw the re-election of Tsai Ing-wen. Less than 15% of respondents to a poll of Taiwanese people conducted on March 4, 2022. Indicated that they would like to see the Republic of China's constitution changed. While 76% of the respondents were pleased with the current situation. We should not be blind to these fundamental distinctions because Taiwan and Ukraine share some commonalities. The legal aspect comes first. Ukraine is a fully acceded member of the UN and recognizes sovereign state on the globe stage. As a result, the Russian invasion violated the UN Charter and was an act of aggression. In 1971, the Republic of China in Taiwan gave up its UN membership to the People's Republic of China. But it is still regarded as the part of One China. Globally, this supports the argument for reunion. A law against secession enacted by China's National People's Congress in 2005 obligates China to use force to interference if Taiwan declares its independence. The final distinction geography makes an invasion of Taiwan extremely challenging. Since the region is flat, an invasion of Ukraine should typically be easy in terms of terrain. Tanks and other types of vehicles can easily roll over the border. Taiwan, in contrast, is a mountainous island with few beaches that is divided from the mainland of China by the large Taiwan Strait. If met with resolute resistance, an amphibious assault would almost likely fail. Therefore, a military invasion of Taiwan would have to be preceded by a naval blockade or a large missile assault to destroy Taiwan's infrastructure. The US and Japan would then have time to respond. Furthermore, the Chinese People Liberation Army is well aware of the fact that, in contrast to the Russian army, it lacks combat experience. Since 1979, when it engaged in a war, the energy system, our phones and other aspects of modern life are all made possible by semiconductors. However, a global scarcity of semiconductors affecting almost every industry has emerged as a result of rising offshore demand for semiconductors, which was hastened by the COVID-19 epidemic. Some people believe that the chip storage will last until 2023 because Ukraine produces more than half of the world's supply of neon gas, which is used in the manufacturing of chips, and because it sets a precedent of a potential Chinese invasion of Taiwan. Russia's invasion of Ukraine has added new stress to an already fragile supply chain, raising concerns for the semiconductor industry. Some refer to the leading foundry, TSMC in Taiwan, as the organization that powers the world's technology and the most significant company in the world because it holds more than 50% of the worldwide chip production market share. Devastating effects on the worldwide supply would result from Chinese dominance over Taiwan's semiconductor production capability. First, Beijing might simply stop the flow of supplies to its enemies. The catastrophic drought that hit Taiwan in 2021 gave us a sneak peek of what it would entail. Chip manufacturing requires a lot of water, so TSMC had to truck water from other areas of the island to keep running. TSMC uses 156,000 tons of water per day. A single point of failure in the supply chain is more likely when there is an excessive reliance on one business or region. The cybersecurity of the parts leaving facilities under Chinese control is a different issue. For instance, one investigation revealed that a small chip the size of a rice grain was secretly installed into server motherboards in Chinese manufacturing facilities, enabling hackers to quietly access the networks of the infected computers. Hardware trojans or malicious circuitry can be placed into semiconductor to change or impair their operation, allow unwanted access or steal critical data, although they are making slow progress. Domestic semiconductor production efforts are ongoing. The Chips for America Act was passed as a part of the FY 2021 National Defense Authorization Act, but it was not funded. It calls for $52 billion to improve the nation's semiconductor manufacturing posture. The US Senate and House of Representatives each enacted their own versions of legislation funding the Chips provisions, but they must reach agreement on a single piece of legislation before President Joe Biden can sign it. The FABS Act, a recently presented measure, would give domestic semiconductor production and research significant tax breaks. It is more crucial than ever that the United States improve its semiconductor manufacturing skills given the rising tensions between China and Taiwan. Lest our enemies control the world supply, therefore, it is unlikely that China will invade Taiwan in full force. If China wanted to take advantage of the crisis in Europe to make military moves in its own region, it would likely try to do something that would be less likely to face active resistance, like erecting more military installations on South China Sea reefs or perhaps annexing islands currently occupied by Taiwan or one of the Southeast Asian states. Beijing would do this to test the US response, which would be less likely to involve a direct military invasion. So guys, this was for today. Give us your thoughts on this in the comment section. And if you appreciate our content, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your family and friends. We will meet you soon in a new video. Thank you. Jai Hind.